Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we will just complete this example which we have started. So we have created actions, we have created reducers, we have created our store, everything is ready. Now only the thing is we just need to create a component who is going to consume the data. Okay, so component can be a simple app.js. we can create app.js that will actually read the data from Redux. Similarly, we can also create another component which is a post list. Okay, postlist.js that will actually list all the posts in app.js. We can simply iterate onto our post list. So post list component we'll be creating. This is simple functional component we have written. It is just rendering the post list component. Okay. So we have created post list. Okay, so in the post list component we have to write the logic which can actually talk to the Redux layer. So how we do it? Simply, if you just talk about export default class we used to write, class post list, which can extend react.component. Right, but how to create a higher order component which we already aware? We just need to, let's keep it a class only because we are not exporting it. We have to export the higher order component, which is we'll be using connect. I'm just writing a simple sketch here. We will be using these two methods, map state to props, map dispatch to props, and our component post list. Here we can import required things. Import React from React. Okay, so now if this will have a render function and all, we can just write it. We are writing class based component. What happened? Okay, return. Obviously, I will be writing a return for this. Simple. Now here we will be using map state to props and map dispatch to props. In our example, you already know that we are not making any action, we are just reading the state. So this method should be enough for us. Map state to props, we are reading the props, we are reading the state, which is blog post with the user information. So we'll pass it. And another thing is map dispatch to props. So there are many ways to write it, map dispatch to props. You can now, Redux is providing a proper binding. This we haven't talked till now. You can actually have one method like component did mount. I'm going to write that will make an API call to this, which will trigger an action. Okay, like this dot props dot fetch posts and users. So I can directly map it here. I can directly say get this data. I am defining it here. So Redux is smart enough. It is going to map this fetch use posts and user to the Redux action we have created. Okay, fetch posts and user, this is how we used to define. So if I just see what we have to do is we are creating this, and same with the same name we have the actions already created from the, okay, I forgot to import action from actions, actions index.js. So in this action we might be having this function export const. So we'll be using selective import, I mean named export. So we'll be importing it, and with the same name we have created this function, right? So there will be a proper inbuilt mapping will be happening. Whenever this component did mount execute, this props method will execute, and we have the same name actions already defined. We can map it here. So you don't need to define map dispatch to props and then dispatch that action. That is being taken care. So whenever this method will execute, it will take care of that. Now in the post list, you can actually, you will get the post information and all. You can actually print that in the return statement, which is nothing but post.ids and all. So how we are getting the post? that we will be getting in the map state to props. So map state to props is mapping the Redux state to our props. So we are getting props.states here. Okay, so we need to actually iterate on to it, and all these things we can do internally. Like what we need to do is we have to return this dot props dot posts dot map. We can actually iterate on to this, and for every post we can return this block. And we can have a key for each and every ID. So we can have a second argument of the map, which will give us a unique index. So we can actually convert this into a div, and we can pass index. Okay, this is pretty much simple. We don't need user header and all. Yeah, so now we actually created a component. This is making API call that is mapped to the Redux section. We got the data. Once data is available, we will see the posts information in the props, list.props.posts. And in the render functions, I am looping onto it and rendering all the posts data, post.title, body, and all these things. And we can also get the user information, which we are getting. Okay, so this is pretty much we have about this. Even like we can also get the user information which we already have in the props. So what you need to do is for every post, here we are getting every post ID, post data. Post data is all about this. If we see this, this is the post data, right? In post data, you have the user ID, and for this ID, we already have a data in the Redux store. So if I just talk about this, if we just talk about the Redux state we have right now, okay, let me unplug this from here. So you can see these many posts we have, and after post, we have this user object also in the bottom, right? So we have for each and every user ID, we have this user object. So based on the ID, we can actually capture the user information and we can show that. Okay, this is pretty much about Redux Thunk. We can talk about further about how to write other different middlewares like Redux Logger and all. But this is pretty much about Redux Promises, Redux Thunk, and Redux Saga and all. We can talk about that. So I hope this example is now making you clear about how to interact with the Redux. We are using map state to props, map dispatch to props to talk to the Redux. Map state to props is helping us to get the state, and that state object is available as a props in the component. Now we can also show the user information because we have the post data, post as the ID. Based on the ID, we can actually in another component which we are can write a user, user data.js. What you can do is you can actually, let me copy and show this what need to be done. Here render function will be a little different. Let's remove it. Okay, I need to put something in the return, so let's keep it till here. Okay, now instead of this, what I can do is I can get users state dot users. I'm getting all the users available, right? But I will be getting the blog post ID from here. I can actually render this I can render this user component here itself, like user data, and I will pass the post information here. So I will be able to access props.data.id. props.data.id will give me the user ID in this. Okay, so const can say user ID. Props.data. It will give me the user ID, and based on the user ID, we can filter out what data need to be shown from the user. Okay, or you can actually write a code here itself, state.users.find, that will give you the filtered data itself, which you can directly paste. So state.users.find, we have the ID, user ID in the on props. state dot on props, here we can access the props of this component. And in this on props, we have a user ID. So it will give us the correct user object and we can actually display that username. Simple. We don't need to access user ID here. So we got the props, this dot, this dot props dot user dot name. If I mean, you can just check if this is available, then only try to print this. You can just do a conditional rendering here. So this is how it works. Okay. Thanks everyone. Thanks for watching. This is all I have about Redux. I will keep adding more videos. This is very basic and simple examples how to interact with Redux and how to write basic examples. Thanks. Bye-bye.